words, I think, are erotic. I think the pronunciation of words. Listen to this. Renate, monsieur. My lips are stuck and I love it. Renate, was that close? Monsieur?
Yes, yes, monsieur, yes. Wonderful.
See, we have names like Abby Schultz. there's nothing romantic about that.
No, not
but
much.
If you say Renate, monsieur, oh. And the French, see, I don't know if they know how to do it any better than we do. They tell you that they do. And you spend a lot of time in France.
Yes.
But the French language is mm-hmm. itself. You know, you can say, go out and clean up the bathroom.
Yes.
It sounds
fabulous. Sounds wonderful. Nobody knows you would insult them.
Renate, body language authority, regular guest of the Pat McMahon program, I'm proud to say. She's an expert, an author of various missives on body language. There's a television show called Lie to Me, and I don't know how many of you have seen it, but Lie to Me is all about an office, an investigative office, mm-hmm. and all they do is they read body language mm-hmm. to determine who's lying and who's telling the truth mm-hmm. and what emotion you're really conveying to me. And I don't know how accurate it is, mm-hmm. but boy, it sure seems as if there's something to it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you believe there's something to it because that's your entire career.
Yeah, absolutely.
Can you tell when somebody's lying almost all the time?
I would think close, yes. People who lie often will keep eye contact, even though most of the people are under the impression that they look away
yes.
or they avoid to look at you. No, in the opposite, they look straight at you like, why do you think I'm lying?
If
I'm telling
really
you
good
the truth.
And they're yes. challenging yes. you, right?
But you can tell that they are lying on other parts. Maybe they touch their face or their ear or their nose or they fiddle with their sleeve or something.
That's
they are
the stuff
nervous.
That's on the television
yes,
show. Yes,
they
exactly.
are nervous in other parts of their body.
But is this scientifically based or is this something Renate came up with as a girl?
No, you can read that in any language book, in any body language book, in any research. Yes, yes, yes.
And so when you are reading body language, mm-hmm. most of the time, these people, the professionals I was talking
yeah,
about,
yeah.
they're not fooled. Are you ever? Can somebody be very good at hiding their body language?
You can learn how to use your body language in a certain way. However, the left side of your face is entirely controlled by the brain as well as the legs. So if you see somebody with a certain stance, you know pretty much if the person wants to be with you or maybe leave the room or maybe likes you, etc.
Well, my legs are crossed and I'm going like this. I probably want to leave the room because I've had too much to drink.
There you
but,
go.
But what kind of body language would suggest that I want to stay with you mm-hmm. or I want to end this conversation as rapidly mm-hmm. as possible?
Well, I would say if you're attracted to someone, since we talk about love and sex and flirtation, etc., you look at somebody just a little bit longer than you would look at a person you converse with normally. So you just keep the eye contact a little longer. Then maybe you make certain moves with your legs, which are sexier for a girl or so. Men usually spread their legs and put their shoulders up and make themselves a little bigger. Maybe they even put their fingers in their belts.
Are they consciously aware of doing that? Because it seems to me like all guys do that.
Yeah, yes, that's why you can recognize body language, because the majority of people do the same things to attract the other sex.
Unconsciously.
Unconsciously, yes, yes.
Can I rehearse those things, though? Can I?
Absolutely.
Can I, if I learn from Renate, where do I get this book, by the way, on body language? Not me, because I'm not going to go out and try to attract anybody.
Yeah.
But if somebody's single mm-hmm. and wants to attract somebody and make that great first mm-hmm. impression with body language, how do they learn to do it?
You can read in any body language book.
No, we want to read it in your book. Where is your book?
I don't have a book out yet.
It says author, though. It says...
That's a poetry book.
Body language expert and author.
Poetry book. Yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes. But body language, you can go to any library and read about it. You can take my seminar. it's actually extreme fun to learn how to observe people. And I would say, don't judge them, assess what they are doing. Don't judge them by just one movement.
Because that always
like
supposed to be, this is, I'm resisting you,
yes,
or I'm putting a barrier.
Yes,
is that always true?
The majority, yes. You hold yourself, you protect your heart and your body from outside sources. It can also mean superiority, that you feel better than others, or power struggle, etc. Now, I gave a body language seminar not long ago, and a lady asked me first thing, and actually she had a back injury, and this was comfortable for her. But now there's a difference. If you really look at people, how they fold their arms, do they have it tight to their chest, or do they just have it lightly folded? So there is a difference.
Can we come to a seminar?
Absolutely.
Can we get private lessons in this?
Yes, you can. I do coaching and seminars, both. Yes.
Well, see, you know what? If you've got a job interview coming up,
yes,
you know, we're talking about attracting him or her.
Yes.
But if you want to attract, these days in particular, a new job, that would seem to be one of those great first impression lessons that you could learn.
Very important.
How many visits do I have to make in order to get really good at this?
You mean in private
the body
coaching
language,
or so?
Yes, yeah.
It depends how much you really want to get into it. How much of an expert do you want to become? So it depends. Body language seminars go from 2 hours to 4 hours to longer, role playing, etc. It depends what you want to get out of it.
I'll tell you what, I've got a pretty good deal for you. For free, coming up, 8 minutes on me with Renata Monsieur. And by the way, she wrote this book about poetry, right? There's a kind of a sexy one that starts, "There once was a man from Hamtramck." We'll let her finish it coming up.